Please put your hands together and welcome to the stage, Clay Wilson.
You stay here for a minute. I just want to say, these guys did this video earlier of the demo back in the 70s. Yep. They didn't mention that the recruit they got from the home was me, so we go back a long ways.
We do.
All right, how's everybody feel? As they mentioned, I have a story to tell you. I have been in Rainbow for 38 years. I started, as they said, a part-time dealer, and I have heard about everything that you can hear in Rainbow. And I've seen about everything that you can see. And after a while, if you've been in Rainbow for a long time, sometimes you get a little bit jaded because you've just seen everything. Nothing excites you anymore because you've seen so much. And the following story I want to tell you changed me. This actually just changed me, Vicky. I had a transformation. I've done this for 38 years. After hearing what happened and watching what happened, I want to do this for another 38 years because it has motivated me so much and inspired me on what's possible in the Rainbow business. So I want to share with you about a beautiful country. We've been here on meetings. We've been here on Paysetter. But Puerto Rico is a beautiful country. If you have not been there, it's just gorgeous. Beautiful beaches, beautiful restaurants, beautiful people. It's just a gorgeous country. But unfortunately, as we all know in the news, something unfortunate happened. And this happened on September 20th. And if you know anything about the news and what happened, they had a horrible situation occur. What happened is a hurricane came through called Hurricane Maria. Now, this was a little different than any other hurricane that they have had in Puerto Rico because it was a dead hit on the entire island. A devastating hurricane. And you've all watched the news and you know what had happened in this hurricane to this beautiful country. Now, with this hurricane, the byproduct was devastation everywhere. These are actual pictures of some of the devastation that occurred in the hurricane. And when you look, if you woke up to this the next day and saw this kind of devastation in your country, you would have a feeling, or I would, of hopelessness. That this is extremely devastating. And one of the worst things that happened is what happened to their infrastructure. Now, with the byproduct of this hurricane, they ended up, as you know, you saw in the news, they lost all the power. The power grid was gone for the entire country. They also, as a byproduct, had no water. They also had no sanitation, toilets. They had no internet, no phone service. They basically just shut down. It's like somebody turned off a switch on Puerto Rico. And when this first happened, Jairo and I had some conversations about it. We were devastated for the people and what was happening with these people. But as far as Rainbow was concerned, in our mind, Rainbow was done for a long time because they had said on the news, Chris, that it might be up to a year before they get the power restored. And even as of today, still about 15% of the people in Puerto Rico do not have power right now. It's still a devastating impact on this island. Now, I want you guys to all imagine something. Imagine your country, or your state, or even your city, and you woke up tomorrow, and your country had no power, no water, no sanitation, no internet, no phone service. Tarsis, imagine, where you're here, I can't see with these lights, but Tarsis, imagine all of France, 65 million people. The entire country, switch turned off. All of a sudden, you don't have all the infrastructure that you need, and you have major devastation to the infrastructure, the housing, everything within the country. What would you do? What would you do? Czech Republic, you wake up tomorrow, the entire country is devastated, wiped out. Georgia, the entire state of Georgia, let's just say the whole state, Chris, was shut down. The entire thing was devastated. No power, no electricity, nothing. What would you do? And I started to think about this for myself. What would I do? If I woke up and this was a situation, and I don't think anybody would fault me for this, I would leave. I would try to get out of there. Because how am I going to survive without these basic essentials in life? And this is what happened in Puerto Rico, that thousands and thousands of people left or tried to leave the country. Now, would any of you blame them for that? I mean, if this happened in your country, you'd want to get out of there because we don't know when it's going to get better. What's it going to do to the economy, Brian? What's going to happen because your country relies on tourism? What are you going to do when this happens? And to me, when I think about it, my first reaction, I think for most of us, would be the last thing on our mind would be, let's get a demo kit, let's get in our car, and let's go try to sell a rainbow. I know we're all strong people. We came to this meeting with motivation and inspiration in our heart. We love the rainbow business. But Chris, would that be the first thought in your mind to be grabbing a rainbow and a demo kit and go out there and try to sell some rainbows when your whole country just got wiped out? Now, we're big boys and girls. We can talk openly here. I don't think most of us would be thinking that as the first thing that we would be thinking. We'd be thinking about survival. We'd be thinking about water, trying to get some water, trying to get our family sheltered. We wouldn't be thinking about doing demos. But what happened is Herminio Garcia, he decided, well, our job is to go sell some rainbows. That's what we do. We go sell rainbows. So he obviously had a bunch of obstacles. So in October, keep in mind, September 20th was the hurricane, all the devastation in the country. He grabbed a rainbow, a demo kit, but he added a few additional things. He got a generator because people didn't have power. So he can't go in and do a demo unless he had some power to be able to run the rainbow. Then people didn't have water, so he got some jugs of water. And then he got an extension cord so he could put the generator outside the house and be able to go inside. Then he couldn't call people, so he went out and started knocking on doors. And I was joking that he had a qualification process when he went to the house, say, is this house qualified or not? Well, if they had a roof and it didn't get blown away, he would knock on the door. If the roof was gone, he didn't bother them. That was his qualification process. But he went out and he started knocking on doors and showing the rainbow to people. And the most amazing part about this is when you talk to Herminio about this, he doesn't think it's amazing. He just thought that's what you do. This is our job. We just go out and do this. Where 99.9% of us would think that's the last thing that would probably be on our mind is under these kind of conditions, go out and sell some rainbows. So he went out in October. 10 days after the hurricane hit the island, right? And he went out, did a demo, made a cash sale, then he went on for the rest of the month and he sold 24 personal sales. Yes, you can stand up. Now, Those of you who stood up, I think we would have stood up just for 24 personal sales in good conditions, with power, with water, with sanitation, with internet, with telephone. He went out without any of those things, and his country just devastated, a country that relies on tourism, the morale of the people crushed, because they don't know the future of their country. And he proved that if you do the demo, people will buy a rainbow under whatever circumstances that you have. But he made that choice. All right. Then what happened is amazing, spectacular, phenomenal. But then the next month, November. Keep in mind, in November now, we are only 1 month and 10 days after this devastating effect in the country. Now, after his example and motivating the other people, and by the way, they couldn't find their dealers, so they had to go around and try to drive and try to find and round everybody back up again. So they went around, they found as many people as they could with less dealers, because they lost so many, couldn't find them, couldn't get a hold of them, or their houses were destroyed and had other problems to worry about. In the month of November, they went out as an organization, 187 sales. Once again, it would be amazing in a normal situation, a normal circumstances. This was under no power, no water, no internet, no sanitation, no phones. Yet they were able to accomplish this. Now, in December, this is now a couple of months after the hurricane. And I know, Brian, it was so much easier in December because at this point, 40% of the people on the island had power. So, Chris, it's easy. Simple. 40% have power. Not a problem. Easy job. But remember, their country was just devastated. The economy was just disrupted. No tourism. People are unsure about their jobs. Don't even know. The nice thing he said was, at least people were home because they had nothing they could do. All right? So, December, they go out. 221 sales. This would be great, like I said, under any other conditions. We'd be excited about it. This is with a country that was just devastated on September 20th, where the entire country was wiped out. And most of us would be thinking about leaving and what else are we going to do or where else are we going to go or just thinking about survival. They did their job, went out and showed the rainbow, and amazing things happened in those situations. And I want you to think about this whole circumstance. It's made it a new model for me. I told you I changed. I have transformed. The new model that I have, and we probably all use it, no excuses. No excuses. I start to think about the stuff that we have. We say, oh, you know, the economy is down a little bit, or they have a new government regulation, or it's hard to get a hold of people when we make phone calls, or the traffic is horrible. I say, hey, wait a minute. We have power. We have water. We have sanitation. We have internet. We have phone. Puerto Rico didn't have any of those things, and they went out and sold 221 rainbows with those kind of conditions. What's our excuse? Anything you could come up with as an excuse could not be nearly as bad as waking up to the devastation that they were facing, yet they still went out and made it happen. As you reflect on your problems that you have each day, compare them to Puerto Rico. I have a new way I'm going to handle problems. This is my new way. You come to me and you say, oh, Clay, you know, we've got this new rule, or we've got the traffic in our country is just horrible. We can't get to our demos, or we can't get a hold of people, as I mentioned before, or whatever excuse you've got. And then, Chris, I'm just going to look at you, and I'm going to go, And then when you're done, I'm going to look at you, and I'm going to say, Puerto Rico. And then the conversation's going to be done. And you're going to come to me with whatever reason that you've got, and I'm going to listen politely, and you're going to tell me the whole big, long story, and I'm going to say, Puerto Rico. Puerto Rico. When you come to me, and you've got no power, you've got no water, you've got no internet, you've got no sanitation, you've got no phones, then we'll talk. Until you have that problem, you don't have a problem. No excuses. No excuses. Now, this is the second lesson that I learned from this situation, which was equally as important. And I'm sure Puerto Rico didn't think about this part of it, but it's why they were able to do what they did. This could have never happened in Puerto Rico if we sold rainbows in a store. Why was it able to happen? All right? So when you look at our situation, we are direct sales. And most countries that are here, you know in the U.S. what's happening. Vicky, we've got this problem where retail business is going down. You go to the shopping malls, it's dropping. By my house, they have a big, beautiful mall about 10 years ago that was there that had aged a while. They tore it down to build a new fancy mall. Well, it's been a vacant lot for 10 years because they can't get any stores to go in there because things have changed. It's hard to get stores retail anymore because of internet and other issues that are happening, high rents and everything else. Retail's dropping. But direct sales is booming. Direct sales is growing. It's in the U.S. alone, it's over $200 billion and growing. And that's our business. With stores, we wait for customers. We open a store, we get the cash register, we get the clothes or whatever we have, or we have a clothing store. We hire the people, we get the inventory, we do everything. Then we unlock the door and we stand back and we wait. And we hope, Chris, that somebody walks into our store and buys something from us. And if they don't, there's nothing we can do about it. We run ads, we do word of mouth, anything we can to get them to pay attention to us. But what's different about direct sales? We go find our customers and we control the rate in which we can do that. And Puerto Rico proved that even when you have no electricity, even when you have no water, even when you have no sanitation, even when you have no internet, even when you have no phones, you can still do the same thing. If your country looked like this, would you even think about going to the shopping mall? Would you go down and buy a new watch? Would you go down and buy some new jewelry? Would you buy a big flat screen TV if you woke up in your country like this? No. You would think about food, water, trying to survive. But when we did rainbow demos, people bought the rainbow. Because when you do the demo, good things happen. So this is a side lesson that shows that we are in control. With stores, we wait. With rainbow, we create. Demos solve all problems. All right? Puerto Rico had a choice. They had a choice. Give up or keep trying. Give up or keep trying. And they obviously chose to keep trying. They chose not to quit. They chose not to give up. They chose to work because we in Rainbow are in control. So just real quick, I want to show you some of the heroes of this turnaround or this survival or whatever you want to call this most amazing thing. And by the way, I don't want to belittle anybody else that's been through any kind of devastation. We know that Houston had a hurricane, and I know in Louisiana we've had hurricanes, and we've had other devastation around the world. This was just so amazing to me because it was the entire country wiped out, and they had such a fast, amazing, phenomenal recovery under these circumstances. And I'll explain that more a little bit later. So let me just show you real quick. First off, we talked about Herminio and Mary Elise. They were the start of this whole thing. As you know, Herminio and Mara Lee spoke at one of our previous meetings, but they've been distributors for over 3 years, and they are the ones that were set the first example to get this whole thing going. He went out in the field with a generator, as you said, an extension cord, everything that happened, 24 sales, has sold 100 personal sales since the hurricane, since September. 100 personal sales. Let's give him a hand. What an amazing job. 26 in December, by the way. Reynaldo, junior and senior, they hit some numbers that would impress any time of the year. But check this out. Crown Prince number 18 and a Tiger Award in December. Crown Prince number 19 in February. Crown Prince number 20 in April, all just shortly after the hurricane hit. Let's give them a hand. What an incredible job. And they were like everybody else. They woke up the next day, looked outside, thought all their rainbow dreams that they had created all their life were just washed away in one day. But because of the way our business works, they were able to not only strive for greatness, they thrived and survived. This is Gisela and Nelson. Gisela and Nelson have been at Rainbow for 2 years. They work together as a team. When the crisis hit, this is a great story. When the crisis hit, they didn't think about selling. They first thought was, we need to help our neighbors. We need to help. So they got their Rainbow, Brian, and they went out and started helping people clean their cars, clean their house, dry things up. And in the process of doing that, they sold 20 personal sales because people were so impressed with the Rainbow helping them, they bought one. This was their best month in business. Once again, would have been great in any other time, but under these circumstances, phenomenal. Jose Cruz, prior to Rainbow, he was an electrical engineer, certainly understands the importance of electricity in our lives, but he couldn't restore the electricity on the island, but he could share the power of the Rainbow with people. He went out 31 sales in December, and he won a Tiger Award for his efforts, a total of 75 sales in the last 5 months under these conditions. Give him a hand. Wow. Madeline Rodriguez, she's been at Rainbow for over 20 years, a single mom. She finished the month of October with no sales, which wouldn't surprise anybody under these circumstances. But following the example of others that she saw and what happened, she went out to have a strong comeback in November, 14 personal sales, has averaged 11 sales since the hurricane, and a total of 60 personal sales since the hurricane. Give her a hand. Unbelievable. I can't get my mind wrapped around it. Juan Sierra, he feels that the hurricane transformed him like it did me. It transformed him. Before the hurricane, he averaged just 4 sales a month. I was working basically part-time. After the hurricane, and he saw what people did, it rejuvenated him and inspired him, which, once again, a strange time to be inspired when you have such obstacles that are happening. But he made a New Year's resolution, and he went out 10 sales a month so far this year, which is his best year ever in Rainbow. Give him a hand. Sal Romain, he went out. His original plan was to open an office in October. Kind of got derailed on that with the hurricane. So he delayed those plans, but he's made 46 personal sales in the last 4 months, and his team has a combined total of 108 sales, and he's going to be opening the office right after the world meeting. So give him a big hand. Great job. Unbelievable. And I can't really go on without recognizing the person that provided this training and motivation and the fortitude, somebody that is a living legend to all of us in the Rainbow business. We know his ability to motivate and train and inspire the people. I just want to give a big round of applause to the father and founder of Rainbow Puerto Rico, Victor Peralta. Let's give him a big hand. Yes, you can stand up for Victor. So great, Victor, so great. People living after your example. Just so you can put this all in perspective, I have a quick little video here I want to show you that kind of sums up what happened and what happened after. So if we can just watch that video real quick, I think you'll have a better understanding of what's going on.
Hurricane Maria.
To Hurricane Maria.
To Hurricane Maria.
To Hurricane Maria.
The island is destroyed.
Prayers are needed for this area.
Tell me what the last 24 hours have been like.
Hell. This has just been horrible. Horrible.
Mm-hmm.
what happened here was repeated right across Puerto Rico. The storm cut a swathe through this island that caused so much damage, it could take months, even years to recover.
We begin tonight with the growing humanitarian crisis in Puerto Rico. Millions desperate for food, water, and fuel.
However, due to disastrous blackouts, cell phones and electricity not working, and blocked roads, many gas stations went days without gas, and it was normal to see long lines of cars waiting for it to arrive.
You know, Momir and I were talking that this is not an amazing story. This is the story of my entire career of Rainbow. I have never seen anything this amazing under these kind of circumstances. Not to belittle anything else that anybody else has done, but it touched my heart so much, I had to share this with you. And I'd like to bring up to stage, if I can, the heroes that made this happen that are with us today in the meeting. So if we can get them to come up and we can recognize them, if we can get Puerto Rico to come to the stage so we can give them the appropriate recognition. And I know Victor is ill. We'll hug him after from the... But come on up. You guys.
Come on.
Gracias. Come on.
Gracias.
Thank you. Come on. Appreciate you. Here, why don't we have Victor stand here at the bottom? It's okay. We'll stand here now. Oh, good. As part of the celebration, Jackie and Victor, we can't repay you for what you've done, but we do have a gold rainbow that we're going to be presenting to you with a nice inscription talking about what has happened and transpired in Puerto Rico, just so you always remember our thanks for the great things that you have done and what has happened here. So if we can get the gold rainbow, I think right here, and then, yes, Victor. So we get everybody here, we'll get a picture. And thank you so much. Thank you so much. Just in closing, never give up. No excuses, no excuses, no excuses. And always remember, Puerto Rico, whenever you have problems. Make a choice to succeed, make a choice to work, and may all your rainbow dreams come true. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
So let's go. Thank you.
Brought home the goods, brother.